Now, many men accept losing some of their hair as part of life, but what if it starts falling out and you're a woman?
Well, around 2% of females do lose their hair. It's due to a medical condition called alopecia, and two teenagers from Plymouth have been working with ITV Fixers, the campaign that gives young people a voice, to increase awareness.
There are thousands of people in Devon and Cornwall who suffer from hair loss, and actually you probably walk past them every day in the street and don't actually realise.
I first lost my hair when I was 10. My mum was brushing my hair one morning and found a bald patch at the back of my head. And within the next sort of 4 to 5 years, I'd completely lost all my hair.
So it's like your crowning glory, and when you lose your hair, you don't feel like a woman anymore.
Alopecia is a lot more common than people think. Some people that suffer with the condition have the confidence to speak about it, but the majority of people don't. My name is Lauren Lyons.
And I'm Courtney Drage. We both go to Marine Academy Plymouth and we're 16 years old. Society puts a great pressure on people's appearance, especially through the media. We're surrounded by lots of images of people with perfect hair.
Because of that, for somebody that loses their hair, it can make them feel quite vulnerable. I have a relative who has it. Through our Fixers project, we want to better the understanding of alopecia and tackle the stigma behind hair loss. I think that the majority of people think hair loss is related to cancer or chemotherapy because they don't know much about alopecia.
Alopecia is an autoimmune disease which affects every type of hair on the body, but it can just start in tiny patches. It can then develop all over the head and all over the body. Alopecia is far more widespread than you would ever imagine it to be. Wigs are so good, so we don't notice it.
There's a few different options here.
We decided to make posters.
I think that's quite good.
We worked with the creative team on how our posters should look.
We held a photo shoot in Plymouth. People with alopecia could come and model for our poster campaign. We came up with the idea that we should put makeup on the models to show that people can still be beautiful even without hair.
Not having hair, it makes you feel very alone and very isolated. At first, the doctors can't tell you very much about it. Two things about alopecia is they don't know why it happens and they don't know how to fix it, and that's a very, very difficult thing for anyone to come to terms with.
It was incredibly inspiring to meet people that have been through experiences like they have and just to see how they've dealt with it.
You know, it affects people so drastically that although it's not life-threatening, it's life-changing. You know, you don't want to go out if you haven't got hair. What the girls are doing is absolutely incredible. There's a stigma attached to it, and this is beginning to smash down those barriers.
When you understand that there are more people out there, it just makes you feel so much better about yourself and takes a bit of a weight off your shoulders.
I choose not to wear wigs or hats because I think it's important that I show that I am myself and I'm not ashamed to be who I am.
There are lots of people that live in secret. With this condition, it would be much better if people could speak openly. Then they would understand that it's not just them, there are a lot more people with this condition.
I hope that people with alopecia that see our posters have more confidence in the fact that there are people out there like themselves, and that people that don't have alopecia now have a better understanding of what it is.
Wow, Lauren Lyons and Courtney Rage with their story. And thank you to everyone in Plymouth who helped them make that film. Really good stuff. You can find out more about their project and other work done by Fixers on their website. The address to go to is fixers.org.uk. That's fixers.org.uk.